WPHM. Jeff Ricker back in the 1-800-CALL-SAM studios. A little Don't Fear the Reaper. The Blue Oyster Cult, I believe, on this. Well, it's now Wednesday morning. Time now for the intermission feature brought to you by the huge year-end deals at your Metro Detroit Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram dealers 2021 Big Finish event. Let's continue to hear from Steve Eiserman and Nick Lidstrom. In case you missed the news, Lidstrom is now the new VP of hockey operation for the Red Wings. Of course, during his playing days, Nick was known as the perfect human. So is he automatically the perfect VP of hockey operations as well? Helene St. James from the Free Pass asks, Eiserman answers.
Perfect vice president to his title, or?
That remains to be seen. He had to earn the other one. He just wasn't given it as the perfect human being. Now he's got to earn that one. I'm sure he will.
Nicholas, what have you thought of the team? I know you were in Detroit earlier in the season. What have you thought of the team as a whole, and maybe specifically Lucas Raymond and Moritz Seider?
Well, I've seen progress throughout the season so far. You know, looking back to a different season last year, but I've seen progress in this year's team. I watched not every game, but bits and pieces of games, and I've seen the improvement in all aspects of whether it's goaltending or defense or the forwards. I think we've seen progress. And that goes to the new guys, the two rookies that you mentioned, and Lucas Raymond and Moritz Seider. They've added right away. They stepped in and played well for the team. And I think that shows that the team and we're on the right track. We're doing things to get better, and those young players will help us.
And, okay, last question for me. How soon do you get Holmstrom on board?
Homer, I think, we'll leave aside to start with anyways. Well, it might be easiest that way.
Thank you.
Next, we're going to answer. Con, I'm live.
Yeah, hi, Nick. Just you obviously had tremendous success with the Wings over your 20 years. And how much pride would you take in helping, having a part in restoring the franchise to prominence?
I think we all want to see the team and the organization make progress and become better and start making the playoffs again. So I think that's a goal for everyone. And if I can be a small piece of helping out in different areas, or whether it's in amateur scouting or watching the prospects that we have here in Europe and overseas in the U.S. and Canada as well, but just help help in and chip in to help out to make this team better again.
Is there any one particular aspect of your job that you're looking forward to the most, looking at scouting prospects, player development, anything in particular?
I think just getting involved again. And being here in Sweden, I'm going to be following the European prospects a little bit closer than the North American ones. But I'm looking forward to seeing the development in players like Simon Edmondson or Albert Johansson, players that we have drafted that are playing in the Swedish Elite League here, SHL, and see them make progress. But at the same time, I want to see the team, the Red Wings, make progress as well. So I'm looking forward to a lot of different aspects of this game.
And just your thoughts on just the importance, the growing importance of the draft. I know, obviously back in the day, the Wings would make huge splashes in free agency and trades, but now how important it is to draft and develop players. Just your thoughts on in that area.
I think it's very important. Looking at how hard it is to sign free agents with a salary cap, finding players and developing players is key. Looking at the team we have on the ice right now, we have two young players that stepped in and made the contributions right away, and that's what you want. It's not going to happen to all the draft picks that the team select, but hopefully you'll find the odd player that's ready to step in right away. But development is so big, such a big key for team success, even looking at other teams as well. Development is such a big part of it now.
Thanks, Nick.
Thank you.
Next, we'll go to Max Boltman, The Athletic.
Hi, Nick. I believe you did a little bit of scouting for the franchise a while back. I'm just curious what you took away and learned from that experience.
I think it's hard to watch 17-year-olds and to find and see what they're going to be in a couple of years or down the road, 10 years from when they're drafted or looked upon. And that's the hard part. I think you can see the high talent, but if you can find the gems that are in the rounds maybe 5 through 7, where it's not as easy to select players that you hopefully will and one day will make it to the NHL. So it's hard. It's hard to find talent where there's so many players, so many good players around.
Nick Lidstrom back with the Red Wings. You gotta love it. What a hire by Steve Yzerman. Coming up next, we'll check the out-of-town scoreboard. You're listening to Detroit Red Wings.
Come out the winner. That personal touch that means so much. Just say clear, that's what we do. We take care of all of your needs. We make it so easy for you. Dedicated to quality service and repair. Center.
Quality service and repair. Now that's St. Clair Collision Center, open to serve you. And if you want to have your vehicle looked at or repaired by Mark Peterson and his expert staff, call to schedule an appointment at 326-4520. Whether it's removing a scratch, replacing a taillight, or complete vehicle repair, St. Clair Collision Center is there for you. Call them today. That's 810-326-4520.
Dedicated to quality service.
You can listen to WPHM Radio on your Alexa or Google device. Fueled by Foster Blue Water Oil. Simply enable the 1380 WPHM skill. Then ask your device to play 1380 WPHM. Local news, talk, and sports is just a voice command away when you use your smart speaker to listen to 1380 WPHM. Again, those magic words to hear our radio station on your Alexa or Google device is play 1380 WPHM. Fueled by Foster, the local news station is 1380 WPHM.
After much deliberation and legal challenges, Michigan has new legislative district maps.
We recognize there's probably some things that some folks like and other things they don't.
Stay up to date with the latest news at WPHM.net.
Masks will be required to enter all St. Clair County school buildings.
The modeling for Omicron is predicting another surge as early as January.
Your news authority is 1380 WPHM.
Welcome on back. 1-800-CALL-SAM-STUDIOS. Check the out-of-town scoreboard brought to you by St. Joe's Plus. IHA members of Trinity Health find power in the plus. Game's going on right now. It's Wednesday, and the Maple Leafs and Golden Knights are in a good one. Late third period, 3-3 game. Nylander and Matthews score for Toronto. How about the Penguins all over the decks in Anaheim, 3-1? That's late third period in that one. Evgeny Malkin back with Pittsburgh. Unbelievable. Not one, but two goals today as the Penguins lead at 3-1, looking for their 21st victory of the season. Speaking of victories, let's see if the Red Wings can get one. They're in San Jose, and they're tied with the Sharks 1-1 after two. Let's get you back to Little Caesars Arena. Ken Cal and Daniela Bruce, get them 2 points, will you?
All right, Jeff, thanks a lot. Both the Red Wings and the Sharks have made their appearance out onto the ice surface, and we're moments away from the start of the final period. Red Wings get that late goal by Tyler Bertuzzi from Philip Ronick and Mo Sider, 19:38 of that second period, and the game is tied 1-1. Shots on goal in the game, 26 for the Sharks and 12 for the Detroit Red Wings. Also, Hockey Town, there's never been a better time to experience Red Wings action live at Little Caesars Arena as a member of the Wing Wheel Nation. Placing a deposit as low as $50 puts you on the priority list to select the best seats in the house and enjoy year-round benefits. For more information, visit DetroitRedWings.com/WingWheelNation. Well, Daniela, the Red Wings with that late power play goal, tying it up 1-1. Timo Meier opened the scoring in the first period, but a big power play tally for Detroit.
That's right. A great advantage for them. Great to take advantage, I should say, of the 5-on-3 situation they had at the end of the second there. And again, Filip Hronek heavily involved in the play. He had the 5-on-3 goal in Sunday's game against Anaheim, and this time he threw it in front for Tyler Bertuzzi to tip right into the net. Tyler Bertuzzi with his 17th of the season.
We're having a little technical difficulty right now as we have lost the video on our monitor. So we are calling the game from Little Caesars Arena. Hopefully we can get that taken care of in just a few short moments here. But this gives us an opportunity to tell you a little bit about the San Jose Sharks in particular, because they're a team right now that is fighting for a playoff spot. And right now they're a team that wants to make the playoffs and really kind of a surprise team. At the start of the season, I didn't think that they would have enough to make it. But seems like they've got a chance to get that wild card berth.
Yeah, really the whole Pacific Division has been interesting between Anaheim and San Jose. You see all those teams in the mix, and I don't think anybody expected that.
No, and the team playing in the East pretty well right now are the Boston Bruins. Mm-hmm. And the Bruins picked up a big victory last night. They posted 7 goals in that game. Matt Grizzlick, a defenseman for the Boston Bruins, actually had 5 points in that game. And he's only the 5th ever defenseman in Boston Bruin history. When you think of all their great defensemen like Bobby Orr, to ever have 5 points in a hockey game.
Yeah, and they are just ahead of the Red Wings right now in that final wild card spot in the East, 4 points behind.
Well, we're going to get back to the live action right here, and the Red Wings have just scored a goal just when we got the picture back, and I can't tell you who scored right now. The one lead.
Look at that. It was Nick Leddy who scored the goal, Ken.
Well, Nick Leddy came in and made his way between defenders into the left faceoff circle and fired a wrister behind Hill. And that early goal, 1 minute and 48 seconds into the period, gives the Red Wings a 2-1 lead.
Well, unfortunately, all of our fans didn't get to hear Ken's goal call on that one, but maybe the feed should go out again. Maybe when it comes back, it'll be 3-1 Red Wings.
So it's kind of like the days when Ronald Reagan, I guess, was calling those baseball games with the ticker tape. But we finally got the picture back, so we're in business right now, and it's a surprise right now. The Red Wings are on the board now with a 2-1 lead over the San Jose Sharks on the goal by Leddy, and that's his first goal as a Detroit Red Wing.
Yeah, what a big moment for him. Nick Leddy has contributed to this team ever since the trade. Great to see him get on the score sheet and at a very big moment.
Well, the puck is sent around the boards, and the Red Wings continue to apply the pressure. Fresh sheet of ice. Right circle a shot. Hill looked behind him, and that one was wide of the goal and along the near wing. It's poked up and played out to center ice, and scooping it up for Detroit, that is Mo Sider. Now it's played in front of the Detroit bench. Sider to pick it up. Berkeley in there trying to check his man, but the Red Wings now with a little bit of jump here in the third period. Drop it back, and Sider lays it up the left side to Osterley. Rink-wide feed over to Joe Valeno. Puck was stolen. Now it comes over to Merkley moving in. Right circle, the shot deflected away and off a shin pad of a Red Wing player, and the Wings will just dump that puck out to the San Jose blue line. Earn slaps it ahead. Now charging over the line. Here is the forward, Vial, and he scores. He pounded his way in, ran into the goaltender, and the referee behind the goal is signaling it's a good goal, and the Sharks have tied it 2-2.
Well, that's an interesting first 3 minutes into the period. It's now 2-2, and Ken, just a note about the Red Wings goal. It looks like Hronek and Bertuzzi picked up assists on that one, so a two-point night for each of them.
Vial just made a power move and ran into the goaltender, and I think his leg put that puck into the net. This will be interesting if this is called goaltender interference right now. I think the Red Wings could challenge this because Vial just ran into the goaltender, poked it towards Nedeljkovic, then his body carried him into the goaltender Nedeljkovic, and that puck went into the net. So will the Red Wings challenge this right now? If not, the game is tied 2-2.
Jeff Blashill has been pretty smart about the plays that he chooses to challenge.
I think they have to challenge.
I would,
this
yeah.
One.
Yeah, that it's really close.
Blashill is chomping on the gum, shaking his head, and I don't think they're gonna question this. Nope. They're saying it's a good goal. So it's a 2-2 tie, and we're early in this third period, 16:34 to go. Into the far corner, Weatherby got it behind the Detroit goal. Now it comes back towards the line. Burns with a shot, pinballs in front, rebound. Agliano wristed one wide of the goal. Now Rasmussen to scoop it out the center ice and flip it down into the Shark end. Quite an interesting start to this third period as the puck comes back to the blue line. Sider shot and a rebound chance by Rasmussen from right out in front. Set a backhand wide to the right goalpost. Wings hold it in. That's Osterley shooting the puck towards the front of the goal. Make that Namestnikov. And Hill, a busy goaltender here in the third, comes up with a save.
A very busy first 4 minutes. And as I mentioned, Ken, Hronek and Bertuzzi picking up assists on Nick Letty's goal. Hronek and Bertuzzi both with two-point nights.
And tonight's third period is brought to you by Bill Brown Ford, proud to be the number one Ford dealer in the world. I really thought the Red Wings were going to question this because, Vial just pounded his way into the goaltender Nedeljkovic, but Lashel said, nope, it's a good goal, and now the play is offside up across the blue line.
I would like to know the reasoning on that one, Ken.
Well, he did get his stick on it, Vial did, and then his momentum carried him into the goaltender Nedeljkovic, and the puck went behind the Red Wing netline.
I think Ned might have thought he had that one.
And, of course, if you lose the challenge, then you get a penalty, too.
That is true.
So we're all knotted up, two goals apiece, third period. Red Wings and the Sharks, final game of this three-game California road trip for Detroit. Red Wings will return to action on home ice on Thursday as they take on the Winnipeg Jets.
Couple of games at home this weekend, Thursday and Saturday.
Got the Buffalo Sabres come into town on Saturday, and then the Red Wings have an afternoon, rare Monday afternoon game against the Buffalo Sabres in Buffalo. Wings have to make up five games, trying to bust through the defense. That was Fabry, but the puck was taken away and shot back into the Red Wing zone. Philip Hronek circles on in front of Nedeljkovic. Game tied 2-2. Both teams in the middle of a change. Garabanov in deep, but the Red Wings settle it down. Nick Letty, who scored here for the Wings in the third, outlets it up the left side as Adina charges out to center ice. Flips it into the corner. Speeds after it. Vlasic's going to get there first to play it to Merkley. Along the left side, Meyer backhands it, not out. Suter holds it in, got it over to the right side of the ice. Back to the blue line it comes, and the play whistled down as that puck was shot into the protective netting by Mo Sider.
And according to the NHL's website, it looks like Brent Burns picks up the assist on VL's goal. That puts him at 25 points on the season, two assists here tonight.
Yeah, he's been on fire. You mentioned he had all three assists on Hurdle's goals in that hat-trick game that he had against the Philadelphia Flyers. Yeah, at one point in his career, he was one of the leading scorers amongst defensemen in the National Hockey League.
You know, between him and Erik Karlsson, the Sharks really have two of the best offensive defensemen.
Not only that, but they log a lot of ice time.
Yeah, that too.
Wing shoot it in, Hurdle on the doorstep, taking no chances with that glove hand save as Alex Nedeljkovic. Tyler Bertuzzi, as you mentioned, he had a goal in this hockey game to tie it up late in that second period. 9 points now. Actually, he's got 10 in his last eight hockey games.
Yeah, he has been on fire lately. Doing it without Dylan Larkin in the lineup tonight, too.
And in case you're just tuning in, Riley Barber started this game. He was in the Red Wing lineup, but he was injured about 5 minutes into the opening period. Sharks control, long shot, and that one just missed the upper corner of the goal. Another drive from the point, knocked down out in front. Lindstrom with an outlet feed to Adam Ernie. Trying to spin away from Merkley. Merkley stole the puck, got it in the corner. Quick centering attempt broken up, and the Wings are on the attack. Pugh Suter through the Shark logo at center ice. Lifts that puck softly into the corner in the San Jose zone. Burns goes in after it. Merkley along the left wing boards. Jams it in along the boards. Vial, who scored the game-tying goal, tried to dig it loose. Got it to Merkley, and he'll play that puck up the right wing boards back into the Red Wing zone. Vial tossed it back into the Red Wing end, and the Detroiters making a change on the go as Lindstrom slides it across to Mark Stahl. Wings are attacking right to left here in the final period. It's a 2-2 tie. Bertuzzi backhands it over the blue line. Intercepted and lifted down the ice into the Detroit zone by San Jose. They wave the icing off. And Lindstrom has it in behind the Detroit goal. Red Wing defender Gustav Lindstrom up the right wing boards with a feed. It's off the stick of Stahl to the San Jose blue line. Sharks play it ahead, busting over the line, moving in. Here's a quick shot by Gregor, and the save was made by Nedeljkovic. Gregor was flying in on goal that time, Daniela.
Yeah, he had quite the speed there. Kind of blew by the Red Wings defense. It was an open look for him.
Now he's got it again, Gregor. Bounced it up across the line, speeding in. Letty's got a beat on him, though. Weatherby checked in along the boards by Fabry, who skates it out to center. Weatherby stole it again. Just outside the blue line, along the near boards. Weatherby got it to his own blue line. Merkley fires it across, and Vlasic to shoot it into the Detroit zone through center ice. Up 20 to go in regulation. It's a 2-2 tie. Wings in San Jose. Out at center ice. Wings tap it up over the Shark blue line. Vlasic backpedals into his own zone and a complete line change by the Sharks. Vlasic throws it over on the left side of the ice. Dick Kaling hurdle out the center. He'll fire it into the Detroit end. Nedeljkovic hands it off to Sider. Now it's broken up into the right corner. Checked in along the boards is Barabanov. Centering attempt. Sider stepped on the puck, now kicked it to him calmly and starts the attack and muscles it up over the San Jose blue line. Sharks bring it back quickly. Hurdle in with a shot and juggling the puck and then hanging on at the top of the crease, Alex Nedeljkovic.
And again, it's that top line applying pressure of Barabanov, Hurdle, and Meyer.
We had the pressure and a good shot on goal, but we have a 2-2 tie here in the third period between the Red Wings and the Sharks. This is Detroit Red Wings hockey.
We turn to family during difficult times, and that's why clients turn to us, because we are family.
Because of calling Sam, I was able to get back to doing things that I like to do. I was able to come out of this a better person. Had I not called Sam, there would be physical and financial burdens that I don't think I'd be able to handle on my own.
Our family will never stop working for you, because that's what family does.
You already know Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan gives you access to the largest network of top doctors and hospitals. What you may not know is that with our 24-hour nurse line, online visits, whole health support, urgent care, and more, you can access the care you need whenever and wherever you need it, giving you the confidence in knowing that you're covered anytime, anywhere. We're here for it all, and always will be. Learn more at hereforitall.com.
What do you want from your sports book? The best odds, daily personalized promotions, same game parlays you can boost for even bigger payouts? How about a faster app with easier withdrawals and complete security? Sounds like you don't want to just bet. You want to live your bet life. When you bet with PointsBet, an official partner of the Detroit Red Wings, you get better odds and bigger payouts, all in a fast and reliable sports book. So download the app now and sign up with code REDWINGS to get two risk-free bets up to $2,000. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-270-7117.
Two tie between the Red Wings and the San Jose Sharks. Letty and Vial, the goal scorers for both of their clubs here in the third period. This game is brought to you by Cash2Bitcoin.com. That is Cash, the number 2, Bitcoin.com, the official crypto ATM of the Detroit Red Wings radio network. A couple of power play goals in this game. Meyer had a power play goal for the Sharks in that opening period. Tyler Bertuzzi with a man advantage goal in the second.
Yeah, Tyler Bertuzzi, as we mentioned, has been on fire. 10 points in the last 8 games.
About ready to get going here in San Jose. And from the face-off, here's Barabanov trying to work it out in front of the Red Wing net. Spins with it in the corner. Got it to the line. Burns on one knee. Fired a shot. Got a lot of leverage on it. Fired it wide. Mestikov chipped it up across the Shark blue line. Ferraro dumps it to Burns, who lifts it up the left wing boards out to center ice. Sider picking it off for Detroit. Got it back over the San Jose blue line. Now it skips out to the blue line area. Across on the right side, Ferraro got it out to Hurdle at center. Hurdle checked off the puck as the Wings drive it back in behind the goal. Aiden Hill stops it, rolls it softly into the corner. Burns fumbled the puck. Red Wings in there to pick it up. That's Rasmussen. To Nemestikov, in behind the net. Nemestikov slides it into the slot, comes back towards the blue line. Held in by Gustav Lindstrom, got it to Rasmussen in the corner. Good work by the Red Wings along the board, trying to make something happen and get the lead again. Osterley from the right point, now to Adam Ernie. chipped off his stick, came out the center, and the Red Wings have to regroup in the neutral zone. A little bad break for the Red Wings right there.
And you mentioned it, playing well against the boards. The Red Wings really going in and battling hard and coming away with most of those battles.
That's where it all starts. You got to win those battles along the boards. Good things usually happen when you do win those battles as the Sharks play it deeper into the Red Wing end. Game tied 2-2, almost halfway through the third period, 10:13 to go. Stahl shoots it into the San Jose zone. The puck is lifted around the left side, out to center ice, and into the Detroit end. That was close to offside, moving in with a backhand. Delkovic made the save as Couture tried to put it home.
That was a nice little give-and-go play. Couture right in on Alex Nedeljkovic, who made a big stop.
Timeout comes with 9:58 to go in the final period, a 2-2 tie between the Red Wings and the San Jose Sharks. This is the Detroit Red Wings Radio.
WPHM.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him going on to fascinate millions with his talent? 1 in 260,000. The odds of this born racer having 157 career top 10 finishes in NASCAR? 1 in 125 billion. But every driver seeks the pinnacle of their achievements. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 68. I'm NASCAR driver Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism. Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs. Early diagnosis can make a lifetime of difference. Brought to you by Autism Speaks and the
Ad. Live. Here's what you missed on the WPHM Morning Show with Paul Miller.
We're talking with Pete Zatmerik at Lake Superior State University. Their list of banned words and phrases is out for 2022. And topping the list, wait, what?
A number of our nominators talked about how it's a failed response to try to express astonishment, misunderstanding, or disbelief. And as several of people also pointed out, I don't want
to
wait.
Paul Miller weekdays from 6 to 10 a.m. on 1380 W.
There are thousands of dollars worth of new tax credits on the table. Two, you have to file for them to make sure you get the right amount. Three, a Jackson Hewitt Tax Pro will help track down every credit you deserve. Tax credits for being a parent, taking care of a parent, going to school, and so much more. You don't want to miss out on thousands. Jackson Hewitt knows that. Discover thousands in tax credits and get your biggest refund guaranteed. Learn more at jacksonhewitt.com.
Now an important message from Exergen. A critical new FDA study proves that the widely used non-contact thermometers are not accurate and have high probabilities for false negative readings. New COVID strands are on the rise and non-contact manufacturers are being irresponsible at a time when accuracy matters most. Accurate temperature measurements are essential. Don't wait. Switch to Exergen because they are accurate and backed by over 100 clinical studies. Be sure, be accurate with Exergen. Learn more at Exergen.com.
From Marysville to Carsonville, the Blue Water Area's Red Wings hockey station is News Talk and Sports, 1380 WP.
This whole wall needs to be shelving, too. This is a focal point in our restaurant.
Leilani's new restaurant will have the largest wine cellar in the city. She needs a robust sommelier with notes of procurement manager.
Three sections for France? I mean, this is the biggest...
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. Instant Match instantly connects you with quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your sponsored job description. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
Exergen would like you to know about an important study just released by the FDA. It confirms what the medical community has known all along. Non-contact thermometers are not accurate. The study also reports that they fail to meet FDA requirements for accuracy in labeling. We can't afford to tolerate the rampant false temperature readings from non-contact thermometers. Accurate temperature measurements are essential. You need Exergen thermometers because they are accurate and backed by over 100 clinical studies. Be sure, be accurate with Exergen.
ABC News.
This is 1380 WPHM. Here's your forecast for the Blue Water area. Mostly cloudy for the overnight hours, dipping down to a low of 18. Tomorrow, cloudy skies with a high of 39 and a chance of snow into Wednesday night down to 25. News, talk, and sports all day and all night right here on AM 1380 and streaming live at WPHM.
Area. If your local nonprofit organization is holding a fundraiser or community event you would like to include in these announcements, email your request to news@radiofirst.net. Again, that's news@radiofirst.net. Please allow at least 2 weeks.